The Keller is still on. The game is not over just yet. Less than 40 days after decimating BJP in Bengal, Mamata Banerjee draws blood again.
Mukul ke amra amader ghore dikhele ghore phirlo ei jonno amra obhinondon janacchi.
BJP's national vice president Mukul Roy dumps the BJP.
Sei to ami bolechi BJP korte parlam na korbo na sei karone siddhanto niye ami amar purono ghore phire gechi.
Mamata's former lieutenant is back in TMC's ranks. Didi has scored another big one. Ghar Vapsi of Mukul Roy. Will more BJP chips fall in Bengal? Top focus on To The Point.
Good evening, you're watching To The Point. I'm Preeti Chaudhary. Three big developments happened today with that one event. Number one, BJP's national vice president Mukul Roy is now with the TMC again. Number two, in the offing, it seems, are more BJP leaders who had shifted from the TMC to the BJP. They might also come back. Number three, the hierarchy was made very clear. Who was it who garlanded, welcomed Mukul Roy back into the party fold? Abhishek Banerjee, the rumoured person on the grounds of which Mukul Roy had left the party in the first place. All of that today. Take a look.
4 years is a long time in politics. And in 4 years, Mukul Roy has come full circle. From being in the TMC as Mamata's trusted man, then jumping to the BJP by betraying Mamata in 2017. And now coming back to the TMC by winning Mamata's trust again in 2021.
हम तो बीजेपी छोड़ के तृणमूल में आया है और अभी बंगाल में जो स्थिति है ये स्थिति में कोई बीजेपी छोड़ बीजेपी में रहेगा नहीं.
The money shot was this. Mamata's nephew Abhishek Banerjee, the one garlanding him and inducting him back in the TMC fold. Welcomed by the same man whose rise in party ranks Mukul Roy resented. And the reason why he had left the party. The hierarchical order made clear to the former second-in-command. Abhishek Banerjee is now in that second spot. Word is that Mukul Roy was inclined to return to the TMC but was hesitant due to the Central Bureau of Investigation cases against him. So why did Mukul Roy return to the TMC again? Reason one, Mukul Roy always had resented Suvendu Adhikari even in the TMC. His induction to the BJP was a big hit. Number two, over time he was successively sidelined by the BJP high command. Ambitions of being the possible chief ministerial face in West Bengal clearly crushed with those of Suvendu Adhikari coming in and already a Dilip Ghosh. Reason four, he had always had very close ties with Mamata Banerjee. And reason five, with TMC storming back to power, little leadership future in Bengal for the BJP. With Mukul Roy back in the TMC fold, there are other BJP leaders who switched from TMC. But speculation is rife that they too are looking to engineer a Ghar Vapsi. BJP leader Samik Bhattacharya skipped the Saffron Party meet on post-poll violence. Rajiv Banerjee, the former Bengal minister who switched to BJP just before elections, had slammed the BJP's demand for president's rule in the state. Sonali Guha and Dipendu Biswas too apologized to Mamata for joining the BJP.
Yes, more people will come who have criticized the party like anything. And who have done the betray before election for BJP, for money, for everything, we are not considering them. only we will consider the people who are gentle, who are sober, and who doesn't bitterness, who doesn't go for bitterness.
All of this in the backdrop of Kadar that had switched from TMC to the BJP, already issuing public apologies to Mamata Banerjee, pleading with her to take them back. Like they say, in politics, the game is not over till it's over. The khela is still very much on. With Preeti Chaudhary, Bureau Report, India Today.
So the fact is, viewers, it's a big, big blow where the BJP is concerned. Will they be able to hold on to what they have achieved? Because they have 5 years to go in West Bengal. Cutting across to our panelists, Riju Datta, TMC spokesperson, joins us. So does Tuhin Sinha, BJP spokesperson. Mr. Datta, good evening. Interesting choice of Abhishek Banerjee to garland Mukul Roy back into the party fold. Was that engineered?
Abhishek Banerjee is the National General Secretary of the party, so he welcomed an ex-old guard of TMC, and who was not only an old guard, one of the founding members of Trinamool Congress. So what is wrong in it? No issues about it.
Sir, no, I'll tell you, there's nothing wrong in it. How can there be anything wrong in that? But I'm just asking you, what was interesting is in 2017, if you remember, Mr. Mukul Roy very publicly made his differences with Abhishek Banerjee known before he quit the party. Many would speculate that it was Abhishek Banerjee due to which Mukul Roy had quit the party. So it was interesting, visually, optically interesting, that you chose him to garland him back into the party.
See, Preeti, I'll tell you, you know, you are a very senior journalist, and you know, in politics, one day is a long time, and 2017 is 4 years back. Things change, times change, people change, and obviously Abhishek Banerjee is our National General Secretary, and he welcoming a very senior leader like Mukul Roy is just following protocol. I think we should not speculate too much into it.
All right. You know, but speculation is what journalists do, and
of course,
but you know, I'm going to go across to Tuhin Sinha. Mr. Sinha, it's deeply embarrassing. Your national vice president today is back with the TMC, and he says he's not going to be the only one. Many will follow suit.
Preeti, you know, from the time that BJP was formed in 1980, of the 31 years that we have been in existence, we have been in power for only 14 years. So every time we have been out of power, none of our genuine followers have left. If somebody who had joined BJP merely with the hope of BJP coming to power in Bengal, and if that person cannot bear being in the opposition for a few weeks, then it's good riddance for us.
Few weeks, Mr. Sinha? I'm sorry, I'm going to let you continue, but you said a few weeks. Are you looking to dislodge the Bengal government in a few weeks' time?
No, I said the elections were over on 2nd May. So it's been a few weeks being in the opposition. If he could not be in the opposition, if he could not survive in the opposition for a few weeks, then that person has no place in BJP in the first place. But having said that, let me tell you that Mamata Banerjee, you know, uses it as a show of strength for her national ambitions. That will not happen, because in the last few weeks after winning her elections, her image is of a person who can, you know, who can arm twist democracy and the federal structure of a country, who presides over violence of the worst kind. So these things won't get washed away by this gentleman coming back to her party.
You know, Mr. Sinha, I know, Mr. Datta, you want to come in? I'll come back to you, but I want to ask a quick question to Tuhin Sinha. Mr. Sinha, it's not about national ambitions. I think the BJP right now has it, when Mamata Banerjee is concerned, enough on their plate in West Bengal. Whatever bit you've been able to garner, you might not hold on to. Your cadre is going through villages, pleading to Mamata Banerjee to switch back to the TMC. You have leaders after leaders who clearly seem to suggest are trying to engineer their way back to the party. You had Mukul Roy today. He's not any leader. He was your vice president, for Christ's sake, and he's now back into the TMC's fold.
You know, these, like I said, I mean, BJP has been in opposition for a very long time, so these setbacks don't deter us. But it's rather a reflection of the character of those people who joined us hoping that BJP would form the government, and now they, you know, they're finding it difficult to be here. But anyway, like I said, you know, if there are people joining the TMC back, to a large extent, it also has to do with a violent culture that Bengal has witnessed in the last few weeks. In fact, your own channel, day before yesterday, I saw some footages, has been covering that violence. So if people are scared for that life, for their lives, and in that fear they want to join the party again, TMC again, that I think is a reflection of what Bengal has been reduced to after Mamata Banerjee won by such a good majority.
All right, okay, Riju Datta. Mamata Banerjee has to run that state now for the next 5 years, and it would be impossible politically for these individuals to actually survive. So therefore, to make that switch now, because it's under duress, under pressure, is what Tuhin Sinha suggests.
I, you know, with all due respect, you know, Tuhin has to defend the indefensible today, so I gave him the points. But slanging the national vice president of BJP joining TMC now is as historic as he was at par with Vasundhara Raja. If Vasundhara Raja joining Congress, it is as par with that. Now, will he also say that a Congress turncoat like Hemanta Biswa Sarma, who is the CM of Assam now, with BJP, is actually a congressman? So his argument, I don't know what he's trying to prove here. The bottom line is the BJP unit in Bengal is totally in shambles. They have to admit that. They have to introspect. It's a historic day when their national vice president has changed ranks. What they should do is they should see what is happening between the leader of the opposition, Shubhendu Adhikari, and Dilip Ghosh, their state president. It looks more like an episode of Big Boss, the way BJP state unit is functioning. So forget us. We have got the people's mandate. We have got 213 MLAs. We don't need to add more. It is people of BJP who are not comfortable there, who we think will strengthen us in our national agenda going into 2024. Remember, Mukul Rao was also an ex-railway minister. So he's not an ordinary MLA. He's an ex-railway minister. He knows Delhi very well. And he was critical to BJP in getting 18 MPs in the 2019 elections. So he's a very important person. He's the national vice president who has left BJP and joined TMC. It has
All
never
right,
happened
okay.
post-2014.
You know, okay, you know, we talk about, you know, those who have to leave will leave. But, you know, it is an embarrassment, Mr. Sinha. Why is it so difficult to accept? Let's look at your list. You have 11 national vice presidents. Out of them, 4 are defectors, including Mukul Roy, Bijan J. Panda, Anupriya Devi, D.K. Aruna. All 4 of them are defectors, and you've made them national vice president. Would you reckon somewhere that politics needs to be questioned?
No, if there are 2 aspects over here. See, if I have to turn it around, what self-respect does Mamata Banerjee have that after winning by such a superb majority, she needs to reach out to all those people who in the last 2 years have badmouthed her nephew and her? Does she, I mean, is she really so dependent on these people, or are there certain secrets which they are privy to? And, you know, I mean, there has to be something more to it. Why would she need to these people after
Mr.
such
Sinha,
a
brilliant... Mr. Sinha, by that logic, Mr. Sinha, by that logic, you had... Mr. Sinha, by that logic, Jitendra Prasad, just about 6 months ago, had called Yogi Adityanath the murderer of Brahmins. You took him to your party?
Thank you. Thank you.
I'm not privy to that statement because, you know, he... Of all the statements which have been covered in the last 2 days, none of the interviewers even have spoken about that. So... I don't know from where you
Sir,
are.
You can hold me. You can hold me accountable to this one.
To come to the other larger point that I was speaking about, see, it's a fact that, you know, I mean, apart from BJP, there is no other party which has a political ideology at this point of time. So many of these politicians who shift sides are those political parties who, you know, never believed in any ideology. Political promiscuity, unfortunately, is a reality. And this would happen both ways. There are people desperately wanting to join the BJP. One day you will find people who are joining the BJP that there will be a day where you have someone leaving
the
BJP.
Okay, all right. You know, I want to flip that around. And I want to bring you Riju Datta. If you're going to start taking back all the defectors in, what about those who stuck with you through a time which was uncertain?
See, Preeti, I will tell you something which categorically my Supremo has said today. We will not take back the people who have joined BJP just before the elections for their personal ambitions, money, or to save themselves from investigative agency or whatever. We do not want bitter people. Mukul Roy joined BJP in 2017. He did not join just before the Bengal election. He joined in 2017.
Okay.
And during the elections, he never badmouthed TMC. Whatever the differences were, he has come back. And we welcome him because he's a, like I said, he's a very, very, very senior leader. And we welcome his expertise in the party going with our national agenda. As simple as that. And with Tuhin, I was hearing what all he's saying now. BJP has no ideology to him. Your ideology is to win elections. That is what BJP is following. That is why in only few states you have clear majority. Other states you
have... But Riju Datta, this is politics. So by that, okay, even if it is that...
No, sir. Let me agree. I am agreeing to it.
Even if it is that, there's nothing wrong in that. A party's ideology should also be on the... should also rest on the fulcrum of wanting to win elections. But okay, I want
to
ask you...
that it's all about winning elections now.
Okay. Okay,
so
Riju Datta,
keep this ideology thing. Yes.
Let's talk about your party's ideology. You said very clearly that your party supremo today has also made clear that Mukul Roy is an exception because he switched earlier. Those who switched now will not be taken back. Are you going to stand here, sir, today and tell me Samik Bhattacharya, Rajiv Banerjee, Sonali Ghosh, Dipendu Biswas, all four of them will not be taken back because they switched right before? Are you going to give your cadre an assurance as party spokesperson that these four I have named, that none of them will be taken back?
See, Preeti, you're putting me on a spot. Who comes in, who does not come in, is solely the decision of the chairperson. But I will tell you this, what she has told, and you know, she keeps her words. She has said, people who have been traitors, jinhone gaddari kiya tha just election se pehle, they are not welcome back.
Okay.
What more can I say?
Okay, Riju Datta, my job is to put you in a spot, therefore I'm asking. Yes. So all these four did switch right before.
Of course.
And it'll be deeply embarrassing, sir, for you to sit in a debate with me 2 weeks from now and one of them has been inducted back into the party.
Like I said, there is nothing and nobody above my supremo. I will say what she will say, and at the end of the day, it's her decision. It's the chairperson. Mukul Roy has joined the party because of the decision of the chairperson. So whoever the chairperson chooses will join the party. Whoever the chairperson chooses is not right going forward with our party's national agenda, will not join. And I can only categorically name one person who definitely will never be welcome back in TMC. That is the leader.
I like it. I love the way, Riju Datta, you've narrowed it in onto this one person, everybody else who switched right before election. So, okay, one thing we know, Suvendu Adhikari will not be welcomed back. Okay, I want to go back to Mr. Tuhin Sinha. Mr. Sinha, you know, from 76, you've already come down. Now, with Mukul Roy leaving, you've already come down further. Would you reckon by the time this 5-year term ends, you'll be able to hold on to those people that you've been able to get in now? Your cadre wants to leave?
See, I mean, we have confronted so many setbacks in our political career from 2 to this position of 303 that these setbacks really don't affect us much. But I have to, you know, I have to compliment the chicanery of the TMC. Either it is because of Prashant Kishore or whoever, you have a TMC MP, Nusrat Jahan, who holds on to a live-in relationship for 2 years for, you know, whatever...
So what is wrong? Somebody's personal life is somebody's personal life, sir.
This is bizarre.
Who are you to give moral reference points to Tuhin Sinha sitting on this show? Sir, what, sir? Sir, are you going to give moral reference points on how people should conduct their personal lives? I'm sorry, I'm going to have none of that.
No, no, it's not about personal life. It was about a certain perception that had to be carried out till the election.
Sorry?
The moment the elections are over, the chicanery.
What is wrong? What is wrong with that? It's a personal life. She can choose to do what you want. Tomorrow, a debate show dissects your personal life, sir. Is that going to be all right? It doesn't cut in this show, at least. It doesn't cut in this show, at least, sir. Please leave people's personal life out of this. I want to ask you a quick question, Mr. Sinha. I want to ask you a quick question, sir. Does it expose the fact that, sir? I want to ask you a quick question. Please come back. And let's steer away from personal commentary. I want to ask you a quick question. Does what's happened today, what is happening on the ground level where your cadre wants to leave, expose the fact that the BJP did not have any ground support, where your party has not been built at a grassroots level? You've relied on the TMC cadre to switch sides to build your party.
You know, to get the percentage votes which we managed would not have happened without support. But yes, look at where we started from. In 2016, we had 2 seats. So, you know, to completely wipe out Congress and the left, that by itself is a big achievement. And please let me clarify over here, I was not getting to her personal life. I was just complimenting their chicanery. They could have possibly planted these turncoats in the BJP. So we are prepared for whatever happens. Maybe a few other MLAs go. But in the large run, it is good that these people go because they never belong to our BJP
okay.
ideology.
All right, okay. I need to close the show, Riju Datta. I know you wanted to come in for a quick comment. I apologize.
I just want to say this. Whatever happened, it's a historic day. The national vice, the headline okay. is the national or vice president of BJP joins TMC.
All right, okay.
Let
I
them
want
deal with it.
Well, okay, sir. All right. I appreciate you both gentlemen for joining us. Thank you. Up next is Rahul Kawal.